So welcome to online video lecture for the subject high voltage DC transmission, and we are going to continue the session that is the design of filters in HVDC transmission. Okay, so in that design factors, so this is one of the parameter, that is the network impedance. Okay, so why we prefer network impedance and what are the metrics there, so all those things and all we'll discuss. So in general, the harmonic impedance of the AC network at the point of filtering will exhibit the following characteristics. So because the source of the harmonics is the AC, okay, as we have discussed earlier. So if at the starting itself, we are going to filter out the harmonics, means it will be more flexible for the converters to give the maximum output there. So it gives a better performance. So all these external disturbances can be avoided at the AC itself, because the source of the harmonics is the supply frequency. Okay. Next, in that we will see the one by one characteristics, that alternation of resonance, that is of which is of low resistance, and anti-resonance, which consists of the high resistance as the frequency increases. See, because based upon our impedance, as I said to you before, so this impedance are impedance in the sense the filters which we are preferring, it consists of the elements, passive elements. So that is either resistor, inductor, and capacitors. This creates an impedance there. And it should not affect the system impedance. Okay, so because of any these cases, there exist the resonance and anti-resonance case. As I said to you before, because of these impedances, I mean the filter impedances, a resonance condition may occur in the system which should not be happened there, because at the resonance condition there exists only the resistance. All the reactance part will be cancelled out there. That means the reactance part becomes zero. Okay, so if there is low resistance, means obviously the power rises. Okay, so because we are sending the power to the maximum extent, because of these conditions it may rise there and it should not be happened. Okay, and based on this point we need to consider the choice of impedance. Okay, because continuously the resistance part is varying there. Okay, next, lower maximum impedance at higher loads than at low loads. So that's what they, as I said, you know, so based upon the dynamic situation, I mean the dynamic conditions happening there, accordingly these impedance to be varied. So if, let us consider a small fax device there, that is a TCR. Okay, so thyristor controlled reactor. So based upon there, the reactance is controlled by using the switches. Okay, so that is nothing but the dynamic operation. So similar to that, so here these filters are also, we need to vary the impedance as per the dynamic changes which is happening in the system. Next, great change in network impedances due to line outages. So line outages, in the sense sudden, it can be considered as a sudden removal of load. Okay, so during the sudden removal of load, so this impedance also should not affect on the system. Okay, so we need to take certain measures. So likewise, if whereas coming to the facts there, so if there are sudden outages, means we are going to connect the shunt reactor. Okay, so likewise here also, this filter impedance should not affect the system. Of course, it cannot compensate the any fault occurred there, but this impedance should not create any adverse effects there. Okay, next, resonance in the AC network are the rule rather than the exception. So all the problem is that resonance condition, that is the only issue which can be obtained from these filters if there are any abnormal operations. Okay, next, the harmonic impedances bear no relationship to the fundamental short circuit level. Okay, so because fundamental frequency, in the sense the supply frequency. Okay, if there are any short circuit occurs in the line, as we have seen, if there are any short circuit for a short period of time, what are the line changes, how this HVDC system is responding there. So this harmonics, this harmonic impedance, in the sense the filter impedances, so it should not be no way related to the system impedances. Okay, so it should be completely it is an isolated thing. Okay, it is an separate part. It is all these filters comes under an integrated impedances there. Okay, so it should not react to the any failures in the system. That means for example, they have considered the short circuit levels. Okay, next, loads provide some damping. So loads provide damping in the sense, as I said, if we prefer a One second. Right. Next, loads provide damping in the sense, if we consider load in the sense, here the inverter part comes as the load for the rectifier. Okay, so load in the sense, you are not practically applying any electrical load there. Okay, so this rectifier or the inverter station itself, it can compensate to certain extent of these harmonics. Okay, so next, this damping increases with the frequency. So that means this damping in the sense, as I said you before, these harmonics which are unable to clear at the AC side, it is going to be injected to the it is going to be acted at the rectifier station. So there what happens again, there may be chances of increase in ripple content, and there we need to take certain measures there. And obviously it is applicable at the inverter station also. Okay, next. On cable systems, the impedances to higher order harmonics, that is around 15 to 25th, are lower than overhead line systems. So that's what, because why we are focused on a cable system is, if we have gone for underground cables there, okay, underground systems, as we said, it will be around 30 to 40 kilometers. Okay, if we need to transfer the power, which is around 30 to 40 kilometers underwater, I mean, submarine cables and all. So in that particular systems, so there may be the impedances to the higher order harmonics are lower than the overhead lines. So that means the choice of impedance will be higher when compared with the overhead lines. So that means a normal HVDC system, which is of, I mean, all the lines are overheaded. Okay, next. Next criteria is the, next design factor is the circuit modeling. Okay, next. Filter design is complex subject that requires accurate modeling of the behavior of the harmonic source and of the AC system configuration and parameters. So as I said you that it is a complex thing in the sense, because we need to consider the different types of harmonic, that is the order of harmonic. It will be existing around 40 to 50 or around, it may even exceed up to 70. So based upon all these harmonics and their order and their severity and as well as the frequency levels, so which affects total the harmonic distortion and what are the variations in the voltage. So keeping in all in all these things, we need to design the filters. So circuit modeling in the sense, so that is a exactly the configuration. So which type of configuration we prefer for these filters. So based on all these type of harmonics. Okay. So for third order, so what is the circuit we are going to design and what is the dynamic action performed there. So all these things we need to model. Okay. Next. The harmonic source itself is very dependent on the AC system conditions. So that's what, so because if the AC is fine, if the AC, whatever the AC which we are feeding to the HVDC is in a normal operation, that means if the voltage is constant and the frequency is constant, means there is no problem at all. But if the AC itself is not proper, means it may leads to increase in the harmonic levels. Okay, so then the concept of these harmonic suppression becomes quite complex, because these filters which we have placed for eliminating particular type of harmonics or to perform a compensation action, I mean to perform the harmonic elimination, it is going to be varied there. If the AC system it's not proper, so that means if there are any changes in the AC, so which ultimately the voltage and frequency should be constant there. Okay. Next, at present, the converter harmonic currents are calculated using three-phase terminal voltage sources with levels of asymmetry and distortion specified from the experience of earlier schemes. So that's what mean. Actually, how we are going to theoretically calculate the harmonics in the sense, we are considered with the voltages, I mean the input voltages, what is the power factor there, what is the angular there, I mean what is the phase displacement there. So everything we are going to take, and we are going to use the some Fourier analysis, we are going to apply and we are going to measure all those things. So if we consider the third unit there, so that is the DC link voltage, what is the AC voltage there, so what is the inverted voltage there. So keeping in mind of all these parameters, we are going to design a filter, because we need to simulate that to say you exactly. So considering all the data, so by reading out all the required data, so we are going to perform a modeling there. Okay, so there we are going to design a circuit such that we can get an idea that how which type of harmonics can be eliminated, so that they have given that using three phase three terminal voltage sources, that means the input voltages, okay, so and asymmetry in the sense either it may be at the converter stations or at the improper actions at the AC side with there are any AC distortions, as we have seen in the harmonics starting itself, causes of harmonics, okay, so improper AC system, okay, next changes in AC, any internal faults, so likewise, because of considering all these issues, we are going to perform a mathematical operations there. So based on that, we are going to simulate, we are going to design the block such that we can have an idea of that which type of harmonics can be eliminated and what will be the order and what will be the frequency there. Okay, right. So normally computer programs are used in the calculation of the distortion caused by individual harmonics, the total distortion caused by given set of harmonic current, current injections and telephone influence factor. So that is the main criteria there. So why we have done all these calculations means we have taken certain factors there. So that is one is in the design factors what we have discussed, that is a harmonic distortion, so harmonic currents and the telephone influence factor. So these are only the few parameters, few factors we have considered. So in order to maintain the standards there, okay, so for example, if there are variations in the line, it is accepted. To what extent it is accepted? If it is around plus or minus 5%, okay. If it is exceeding the variation, means it is not accepted there because it is crossing the standards, which is not allowed there, and it may cause the issues in the particular plant or any other systems. Okay, so here also coming to the HVDC, so we are considering on the, we have taken the factors, these are the things, that is the, what is the level of individual harmonics there, whether it is causing any damage to the system, how can we define whether it is causing any damage to the system or not, means based upon the readings. So that means whether it either it may be total harmonic distortion, okay, next telephone influence factors, so likewise, so those are the metrics there. Next, the programs determine the most critical combination for each harmonic and the corresponding distortion factor. So that's what I said now. And the highest harmonic voltage, so that is the maximum distortion, occurs when the parallel impedance of the filters and the AC network is maximum. So as I said to you before, because of this filter, there may be chance of resonance condition. Okay, so that is the maximum distortion. So that is extreme case which we can expect because of these filters. Okay, so based on that also we need to model the circuit. So let us consider short circuit. So if we want to design any switch or any other component, so what are the parameters we are going to consider? The short circuit voltage and the short circuit current. Sorry, open circuit voltage and short circuit current. Okay, because in open circuit the voltage will be maximum and it has to withstand that, and similarly if there are any short circuits, so the equipment or the any device, it must have the capability to withstand the short circuit current. Okay, so likewise we are going to measure that, but actually it is not happening, but it is an extreme case. So likewise we have to think about the extreme case and what will be the highest value. According to that, we need to design the circuit. Okay, right. So that case is expected when there is any parallel resonance. Okay, so that means the parallel circuits are preferred there. It is, however, unrealistic to expect that parallel resonance occurs at every frequency and only two maximum single distortions are normally considered for the calculation of the total distortion and TIF. That is, no resonance is assumed for the remaining currents. So it is unrealistic to expect that a parallel resonance in the sense of coming to theoretical part is, it is fine, okay, but practically it is not assumed that we cannot expect that definitely this harmonic should be appeared and this should be the maximum value. Okay, so we cannot read it as only the as I said to you before, short circuit current is 6 amp as we expected. it is not sure that only 6 amps will be the highest value. So we need to consider one more term. So that let us consider it as in 7 amps or 8 amps. Another term also we need to consider. Another highest value also we need to consider, and we have to design the component there. So likewise here also, we have considered two maximum single distortions. So that is one of the factor. Okay, right. So any shunt capacitors present at the converter terminals must be included in the calculations. See, shunt capacitor, as I said to you before, not only the filters, there will be mechanical switched capacitors and mechanical switched reactors which are connected in default in the system. Okay, so that is not particularly mentioned for any type of harmonics there, but it is used for the default. Okay, so default in the sense it is a minimum functioning of these components, because we cannot make completely the grid in off position. Okay, so in that particular situations, these type of mechanically switched components will come into action there. So that is a function, that is the purpose of placing these mechanical switch capacitors and reactors. Okay, right. However, a detailed assessment of the non-characteristic harmonics require iterative computer simulation of the interaction between the AC side converter and the DC side. Okay, so detailed assessment of the non-characteristic harmonics means, so as we have discussed, non-characteristics in the sense the harmonics which are present even under non-ideal operation. So that is practically happening. So ideal case in the sense it comes under the characteristic harmonics. Non-characteristics means it may be any cause. If there is any asymmetrical valve conduction, if there are any connector failures or any biasing or improper characteristics of the switches, likewise many causes are there. So okay, so in that particular situations, what are the harmonics are produced? So we need to do proper iterations by using the computer simulation. So that is the iteration means, so we need to perform the testing methods there. So as we have seen in the power system analysis, so there we are going to perform the iterations. So in the computer simulation, we are going to perform around 100 iterations. So finally, we are going to see the least error. So then only we can fix the value. So what is the voltage there? What is the reactive power there? So likewise, here also, we need to perform the iterations and we need to fix the value such that at the AC side, converter and DC side. Okay. So because these are these ends, which these harmonics are going to be affected. Because of these harmonics, the system is going to be affected. Next, coming to the tuned filters. So the early DC schemes relied almost entirely on shunt harmonic tuned filters, each of which consists of a series RLC circuit tuned to the frequency of low characteristic harmonics. So tuning in the sense we are going to vary the reactance there. So how we are going to vary the reactance in the sense, with the help of the controllable switches. Okay, if we vary the reactance, how can it can be varied in the sense, based upon the harmonic frequency. Okay, if the harmonic frequency is varied, obviously the reactance, which is let us consider XL, which is equal to omega L. So what is the value there? 2 pi F into L. If the frequency is varied, means obviously the reactance is going to be varied. Okay, so based on this procedure, so on that particular frequency, these filters will come into action. So let us consider in the early DC schemes, in the sense, in the previous methods, in the traditional methods, they are going to use the series RLC circuit there. Okay, so let us consider the impedance of the single tuned filter is ZF equal to R plus J XL minus XC. So where XL equal to omega L and XC equal to 1 by omega C. So this is the normal basic impedance of that particular filter. So let us consider it as a single tuned filter. Okay, so where resonant frequency is a pure resistance. As I said to you before, the magnitude of the impedance equal to, it is equal to R there. Okay, so here you can see the passband of the filter is defined as being bounded by the frequencies at which the filter's reactance and resistance are equal. So this is happening at they have given an example that at 45 degrees. Okay, at that particular angle, so the modulus, in the sense the magnitude here is root 2 into R. Okay, so that is the least resistance offered in the in that particular impedance under the resonance condition. Okay, so this is the a filter circuit, single tuned filter circuit, series RLC, and this is the least resistance offered there. So pass band, in the sense between the we can say it as the upper cutoff and the lower cutoff there. Okay, so based upon this, we can define the quality factor Q, which is defined in the previous sessions, that what is about the quality factor. Okay, so this is the least resistance offered. This occurs at the resonance condition. Okay, and we need to consider this during the iteration process. So look at here, omega n, it is the angular frequency there, 1 by root LC, which is equal to 2 pi f into fn, f suffix n, where fn is the resonant frequency. So which is defined as the frequency at which the maximum power can be delivered, or the frequency at which the minimum impedance is offered there. Okay, vice versa. So x naught equal to omega n into L, or which is also equal to 1 by omega nc. So which is equated, we get root of L by C. So based upon this, we are going to choose the inductor, the reactor, and as well as the capacitor. Okay. So and the quality factor. So quality factor, in the sense how it is going to store the energy and how it is going to respond, how it is going to release the energy. So that ratio gives the quality factor. Okay. So exactly it gives the operation there, how this dynamic action can be performed. Often two single tuned filters are replaced by a double tuned filter, because instead of using for two different harmonics, if you want to use the filters, means we can prefer a double tuned filter instead of using a single tuned filter. Okay. This has proved more economical because it uses only one common inductor and the power loss at the fundamental frequency is lower. Okay, so based upon the economic, from the economic point of view, as well as the power losses at the fundamental frequency, that is the source frequency. So if we are reducing the filter's utilization, means obviously it can the impedance gets reduced. Okay, so that will helpful in that helps in reduction of the power losses at the AC side. Okay, so in practice, a filter is not always tuned exactly to the frequency of the harmonic. That is intended to suppress for the following reasons. Let us see. So it is mentioned that we are not frequently tuning the filters as per the harmonic frequency, and there are certain measures we will see. There are certain reasons we will see one by one. Variations of the power system frequency, which result in proportional changes in harmonic frequency. So as I said you, so if there are variations at the input side, that is at the AC side, obviously it is going to reflect at the harmonic frequency. Okay, so let us consider, if we are using any reactive power compensators, there are certain components. If we are going for a shunt compensator, there we are going to inject the current. Okay, then we need to take the current as the reference parameter there. Okay, so there we are going to control the current such that the harmonics can be suppressed. So likewise here also, if there are any variations in the power, the input power, obviously the harmonic the harmonic characteristics also changes there. Okay, likewise, next, changes in the inductance and capacitance of the filter owing to aging and temperature variations. So for this problem we have used different types of filters. The problem is that if we frequently perform the tuning action, so the aging as well as the temperature variations. Okay, so because of these constraints, the filters need to be replaced. It cannot be used for a long period of time. Okay, so that is a drawback. Of course, for this problem can be biased with the help of using the different filters. Okay, based upon their orders. Next, the accuracy of the actual tuning is restricted by the discrete nature of tuning steps. Okay, next, so that is also discussed. That is accuracy in the sense based upon their frequency. So you look at here. So based upon their harmonic frequency, so quality factor in the sense this comes into an action. Okay. So based upon the type of the harmonic, and this tuning can be done automatically. Okay. Right. Next, self-tuned filters. The due tuning effects can be compensated for by continuous adjustment of the capacitor or inductor. So normally the latter in the sense which is connected nearby there, thus permitting the use of high values of Q, that is the quality factor, without having to increase the component ratings. Okay. So detuning in the sense, suppose if any harmonic variations, harmonics occurs, we are going to tune the filters. And again, when the harmonics eliminated, when the harmonic part is eliminated there, and again we have to bring back the filter to its original state. So that is nothing but the detuning. Okay. So that is the case. Can be compensated for by continuous adjustment of the capacitor or inductor. So that is the natural thing. So we are going to balance the reactor as well as the capacitor. So based upon the harmonic levels. Okay. So thus permitting the use of high values of Q. High values of the Q in the sense. So they, based upon their energy storing. Okay. So the type of the size of the elements. As I said to you before, for the DC and the AC filters. So what is the main difference means the size of the elements. That is the only difference there. Okay. So the tuning also, if it is self-tuned means accordingly we need to prefer the, there comes the size of the components. So that is the another thing. Okay. So size in the sense, what does it mean? Obviously the ratings are also going to be changed there. Moreover, the resulting low value of the filter resistance increases the filter efficiency. Okay. So, all right. Self-tuning consists of an on-off servo control, which measures the harmonic frequency reactive power in the filter and automatically adjusts the main filter tuning to near resonance. So that is with filter arm harmonic wires within the prescribed limits. So that means this point is discussed in those particular situations there. So right now, which is not encouraged there. So it is going to be, it is completely different right now. So basic early schemes, they are going to use the servo control. Servo control in the sense, now we are preferring the switches, right? So at the time they used to have the servo control and they are going to perform the on and off operations. On and off in the sense, the tuning purpose. Okay, right. So that it can compensate as well as the reactive power also. So that is the methods there. So where in the sense, okay. Look at this relative cost of filter branch versus capacitance. So right now with increase in capacitance, so what is the cost? You can see here the losses. So figure A represents the losses. So losses are very less. Okay. Based on the losses, the cost is very less. So the cost of inductor. So figure B represents the cost of inductor. So it is somewhat moderate there. And the cost of capacitor. So it is higher because this is the major component there. The cost component. So that is the energy storing element there. And the total cost. So this is the overall cost. So that means if you are performing frequently the tuning action means obviously there will be more losses in the filters and there is a criteria that the cost will be higher. Okay, so it is not an easy thing to replace all the components there. Next, the additional cost of providing the inductor variation has to be justified by savings in the capacitor cost and by improved performance. Okay, so that means it is discussed that how can we balance the cost. Okay, so by adjusting the capacitor, so we can avoid the inductor action such that it can be saved there. It can be balanced. Okay, so that means the most of the pressure cannot be applied at the inductor part. So by compensating with the capacitor also, we can balance such that the overall cost can be reduced there. So whenever the detuning effects are small or when the required fundamental frequency reactive power of the filter is high, self-tuning is not normally considered economic. Okay, so detuning effects are small or when the required fundamental frequency reactive power of the filter is high, in the sense when the requirement of reactive power will be high, in the sense if there are any variations in the line. Okay, so that means this tuning, this self-tuning, these are placed for particular harmonic. Okay, so it cannot be used to maximum extent of the rect pore compensation, whereas other filters can be used for the rect pore compensations there. Okay, so if we prefer means it is not quite economic because of all these losses. Okay, next coming to the high pass filters. So high pass in the sense name itself indicates that if the order of the frequencies are higher, so instead of using the single or double tune, we can increase the impedance value such that it can come into the other category of harmonics for eliminating the harmonics. A high pass damped filter presents a capacitive reactance at the fundamental frequency, that is the, so look at this, this is the second order and this is the third order filter. So this capacitor is directly subjected to the AC line. Okay, so I mean AC line. Okay, so it is going to be interacted with the supply frequency. So that is the meaning of this. At this fundamental frequency, that is a supply frequency, and a low predominantly resistive impedance over a wide band of higher order harmonics. Okay, so if the order of the harmonics are getting higher there, so this resistor inductor or this combination will come into action and these filters will be used. Okay, so this capacitor is going to prevent the filter circuit here. Okay, so actually we are going to perform the tuning at these energy storing elements. So that is a inductor and capacitor. Here consider the second order filter, here the inductor. Okay, so this is going to reduce the stress on these filters as well as it can compensate the reactive power in the line. Okay, next. Since the sharpness of the high pass filter tuning increases with the help of the switches or any other mechanism with the ratio R by X naught. Okay, earlier we have seen what is the quality factor there. So Q equal to X naught by R, but here it is exactly reverse. Okay, so R by X naught. The Q of this filter normally refers to that ratio, the inverse of the expression used for the resonant filters. So it is exactly reverse for the single tuned or double tuned filters there. Okay, and the values of the Q varies from 0.5 and 5. Okay, right. So type C damped filters. Okay, so with the ratings of some HVDC links being of the same order as the system short circuit level, there is an increased probability of lower order harmonic resonance between the system impedance and the filter capacitance. So this is one more minor modification of the high pass filters, that is a type C in the sense there we are going to place the capacitor so that most of the higher order, as they mentioned, with the ratings of the some HVDC links of the same order as the system short circuit level, there is an increased probability of lower order harmonics. Okay, so lower order harmonics in the sense, as I said you, so it has a high severity. Okay, it is going to affect the system. So in that particular, if we consider especially the lower order, that is either 3, 5, 7, likewise. So for that particular type of harmonics, we can prefer this type C damped filter. Let us see how it is going to be. Series or parallel resonance will result depending on whether the lower order harmonic source is within the AC system or converter stations respectively. Okay, so that means of course there is also a problem that resonance condition. So that depends upon, as they mentioned, that depends upon the source in the AC system or at the converter station. That means either at the AC, the behavior of the AC, or it relies on the behavior of the DC there. Okay, so based on their situations, there may be a possibility of the resonance condition, even though if you prefer the type C damped filters, because these are particularly attached for suppressing the lower order harmonics. So this is the C-type band pass filter there. Okay, the power loss of conventional damped filters, so that is the conventional in the sense when compared with the other, that is a single or double tuned filters, can be reduced by a type C filters. So this is the combination. Earlier we have seen combinations are different there, that is the high pass filters. So here you can see another capacitor C2 is attached in series with the reactor. So this is nothing but the C type band pass filter, and here also we are obviously going to perform the tuning action to eliminate the lower order harmonics. this circuit is more susceptible to frequency variations because of the fundamental frequency tuning, but it exhibits much more losses. So okay, as I said, you especially focused on the lower order harmonics, but also there is a drawback that because of the increase in the components, it is obviously going to increase the power losses in the AC side. I mean AC in the sense at the either AC or at the converter side. Okay, so that is one more drawback. And coming to the last concept of this session, that is the DC side filters. Okay, so why we need to prefer the filters on the DC side? The main function of the filters used at the DC side is to eliminate only the harmonics, whereas coming to the AC, there it is going to perform the reactive power compensation also. But whereas coming to DC, there is no concept of reactive power and we are not bothered about that. Only we need to consider only the ripples, I mean ripples or harmonics. Okay, let us see. On the DC side of the HVDC converters, the voltage harmonics generate harmonic currents with amplitudes which depend on known elements such as delay and extinction angles, the overlap angle and the impedance of DC circuit. See, as we have discussed in the working principle or the converter configurations, there exists the parameters, that is the overlap angle mu, delay angle alpha and extinction angle gamma. So likewise, certain parameters are there. We are not going to generate the pure DC waveform. Okay, it is of rippled DC content, I mean the rippled DC voltage. Because of this, there exists the rippled DC current. So for that purpose, for that only, we are going to use the smoothing reactor, which is going to eliminate this ripple current. Okay, likewise, and additional to that, the smoothing reactors, damping circuits, that means the filters such as surge capacitors and line itself. Okay, so surge capacitors, as of course this is also discussed, okay, under the fault conditions there. Okay, at the DC side, we are going to use the smoothing reactors, which is going to smoothen the current waveform, which is of ripple content, and the damping circuits, okay, again to eliminate the lower order harmonics there. And the surge capacitors, if there are any surges attacked on the, or these, if there are any switching surges at the DC side, so these are coming to action so that the equipment can be protected. And in contrast to the AC filters, the DC filters do not carry fundamental frequency power. That means the AC frequency cannot be carried there, and therefore have substantially lower losses. So that is a known fact there. So when compared with AC, the DC losses will be less, even though if you attach the filters there. Do not need to provide reactive power, and their only function being harmonic mitigation. So the only one functioning is that harmonic mitigation, because there is no concept of frequency and there is no concept of reactive power. And finally, have in their main capacitor to withstand the full pole to neutral DC voltage. So in the schematic diagram, you can see, you can refer from the earlier sessions, there a single capacitor is placed and it is grounded there. If during any fault occurs, this capacitor is subjected and it is, and the fault can be cleared. So likewise, we are going to protect the at the DC side also by using these filters. So that's all about the session, the design of filters in HVDC transmission. So hope you have understood this session. So thank you.